Golden armor is still a dog.
What did you say?
He said Caesar is great.
There's a curfew.
Do not be seen on this street again, Jew.
But we must buy food for Passover.
Buy it then, and get off this street.
If I were a younger man,
you surely would have taught him a lesson.
The streets are buzzing, Caiaphas.
It's this time of year. Jews come to Jerusalem from all the precincts.
And I will tell you, Caiaphas, I have a son. He's 3 years old. Back in Rome, I miss him. I want to get back to him. It is your job to keep the peace here in Armenia.
What are you trying to tell me?
My soldiers have arrested 4 troublemakers, so-called prophets. Do you understand me?
If I hear of someone else, I'll hand them over to you.
You have no power to arrest. How does it feel, a Jew handing over a Jew to Roman authorities?
It doesn't feel good. But my responsibility is to protect the law of our people, the law of God. And if I'm wrong, and one of those prophets is a real Messiah, let history judge me.
Let history judge.
Lord, what have we done to deserve such a fate?
For heaven's sake.
What's wrong?
Gamaliel, must he be late on a day like this?
But it's not his nature to be late.
Well, this is not a day to start.
But the Roman soldiers are everywhere. Maybe we should consider his safety first.
I'm sure he's safe. It's just that I say a prophesied that the Messiah would come during these times. Why won't the other rabbis just accept that?
Do you believe that this dark-skinned Nazarene is really him?
I don't know, Nicodemus. But one thing I am sure of. If this Yeshua is indeed the Messiah, I fear we may be too late.
My deliverance shall happen here, my brother.
Today begins Passover, Master. The Romans would not dare violate this holy holiday.
Peter, to those who seek to harm the Messiah, today is just another day.
I do not believe the Romans would want to disturb the peace.
I'm afraid Thaddeus may be right, Peter.
Are we there yet, Master? I'm tired. I can't journey much farther.
Too much complaining from you.
Perhaps we should carry this young girl into Armenia. Come on.
Let's go.
Amen.
Israelites are outnumbered.
He who lives by the sword, Judas, dies by the sword. Go down into Arimathea and set up preparation for the Passover meal.
But Master, the centurion guards are all over Arimathea. Shouldn't we have the feast somewhere more secure?
Do you question my love for you, John? Do you think I would place you in harm's way?
No,
then I... go and trust in me.
Good. I'm sorry, Master.
Good. Now, when you enter town, you'll observe a man carrying a pitcher of water. We'll follow him to his house. There, you will ask the goodman of the house. Tell him that the Son of God has sent you and wishes to know where he shall eat the Passover meal with his disciples. Okay, go. Oh, wait. Leave this.
Quickly. Go. Yes, ma'am. Quickly.
My father will protect him.
Papa, Mother said you'd have the chair fixed before feast time.
Don't worry, I'll get to it. By the way, where's your mother?
She's at market, Papa. But it's almost sundown, and we have all the chametz to still remove from this place and so many preparations to do before then.
Lord, the one trait my daughters inherited from their mother. They worry too much.
Oh, Papa, I'm sorry.
Don't worry, my dear daughter. Will you be having Seder with us tonight?
No, Papa. Ruth and I must be with our husbands. We have only come to help Mama.
Marry off my daughters, and now they have no time for me.
Matzah!
Ezra! You know that's for Seder.
But I'm hungry now, Leah.
Ezra, what do you think God thinks of such disrespectful behavior?
Sorry, Papa.
You go wash up so you and Father can dip yourselves in holy water before you eat.
That's right, son, the mikvah, a very important ritual in our religion.
Hi, Papa. Where's Mama?
She's out to market.
May I ask you a question, Papa?
Sure, son.
It's about Yeshua.
Continue.
I am a young man. And I know that you have done everything to protect us. But I was thinking, maybe I should join Yeshua.
Out of the question. We'll break your mother's heart.
I understand that he has a prophecy to fulfill. But why didn't he include me?
Let me explain, James. Your older brother loves you very much. But these are dangerous times. And he understands his sacrifice is his alone. Do you understand?
Yes, Papa. I understand.
In time, your role will come.
Pardon my delay. My way here was delayed.
Roman soldiers.
Who else? More came to town, doubling their numbers.
They are relentless in their search for the Black Nazarene.
Rumor is he's hiding somewhere in the hills. It may take weeks for them to find him.
This is no good.
What is wrong?
We have been informed that there will be an emergency meeting of the entire Sanhedrin body tonight.
But I was not informed of
it. Hear me, Gamaliel. The entire membership is being contacted as we speak. They think they are near to capture this Nazarene.
It may be as early as tonight.
But how?
Caiaphas has eyes everywhere.
You mean he hired a spy?
Yes, one of the Nazarene's disciples.
And our fear is that this man's capture may lead to more violence on the streets.
You both know how I feel about this carpenter. I have heard him lecture before. He knows the Torah better than most rabbis I know. I find him to be a very learned man. But he's black. And to say that he is the Messiah, it is blasphemy.
The Torah does not mention as to what he will look like.
Not to mention that he is still a Jew, regardless of his skin color.
Passover, the worst time of year.
What's next for you, Horatio?
Keep the peace for 7 days in Armenia. Then I go back to my beloved Rome. Jews, you cannot trust them.
He carries water. He carries carpet. Perhaps our master should heal your eyes. There. There is the servant we are to follow.
In a hurry, citizens?
Only to get my friend out of the city. He sure is to collapse if I don't get him home quickly.
He speaks the truth. The feast will bring me welcome relief.
Don't let me see you again. Lest you celebrate your feast in chains.
My friend, might I ask if we could get a message to your master?
I'm sorry, I cannot help you.
Please!
Our master has sent us the Messiah.
Wait here.
Yes? Can I help you?
Our master has sent us with a message.
And what is the message?
He wishes to know where he will eat the Passover meal with his disciples.
Come, quickly. Come. Is it all right? Is it good?
Yes. Thank you for opening your home to us. And we apologize for any inconvenience. Oh,
please, not to worry. Let the Messiah know that I'm humbly grateful that he has chosen my home for this ceremony.
I will tell him.
Thank you.
Camp here.
Why here, Rabbi?
Open clean space to honor the Passover. What's wrong, Peter?
I'm tired of running around like rats. Having to hide in these mountains. Not being able to sleep in one place for more than one night.
We knew there'd be a price to pay for the truth, Peter.
At least if they were Romans, there'd be some excuse. But not Jews. Rabbis.
Blessed are ye when men shall persecute you.
We have enough water to last us till tomorrow. Some sheep, some dried fish.
Good, good. Take Simon with you. Patrol the hillside. Make sure everything is safe.
Simon!
Rabbi, I'm still...
Not to worry, Peter. My father has led us here. Pray. After we have pitched tent, gather the rest.
Yes, Master. Make sure the sheep are fed.
He's a wild one, Master.
Such beautiful fur. If only mankind would embrace that which is different. Black sheep.
We've been traveling all night. Who do you think gets to sleep in the tent tonight?
The sheep, Philip.
Hold that steady, Matthew.
For heaven's sake, don't miss!
Your right hand, Matthew, has always been a bit useless. Perhaps if I miss, he'll be able to develop the left.
Funny, Thaddeus. Hey, can you people help us? It's not fair that only two people set up the tent while the rest work.
Oh, no, Matthew's right. He shouldn't be the only one to get his finger crushed.
2 feet, 1 hand, no brain. He's a centurion guard.
Thaddeus has a reputation in Jerusalem for breaking hands.
No, even my hand was broken. That's for not paying your taxes.
Stay there, Matthew. I'll crush your hand later.
Matthew is right. We must all help. Good neighbors. It reminds me of a story our master told us. The story of the good Samaritan.
Oh, come on. Get out with the story.
It worked for our master.
The master's a better storyteller than you.
Yes, that is true. But I'm a better cook.
That's not funny.
Why so quiet, Bartholomew?
I really love these times.
I understand. You know, the beauty of family is that when I first started following our master, I had just one brother. Now, I have 12.
Come, come on. Come, quickly. Hurry. Hurry.
Where are you two followed?
We were extra careful and took a back road.
Good.
Where is our master?
He's up here. He's waiting for you. Come quickly.
Sorry to bother you, Master.
My father can be very selfish
with our daily conversations. What news do you bring?
The goodman has sent word that he would be honored to have your presence in his home.
Good. Gather the rest.
If I don't leave now, death might be late for mikvah. Come, James, hurry.
You all be sure to be careful. Please.
Don't worry. We'll be careful. James, take Ezra into the courtyard, please.
Yes, Father. Come.
Look, Mary, we can't change what is. I know how you're feeling. I would like him here as much as you. But he's not ours anymore.
But I feel it is we who have led him down this path.
Stop blaming yourself for what is happening. We knew this day would come.
Nothing can prepare a mother for something like this, Joseph.
33 years ago, you told me that you felt something happening inside of you. And I truly believe that God did touch you that night. Somehow, something divine happened, and you were chosen among all the women in Judea to carry the chosen one.
Do you think they're doing this because he's black?
No. They're doing this because he's the Messiah.
Master, may I ask you a question?
You may, Thomas.
How does it feel to be a difference?
In my father's eyes, Thomas, we are all different. Yet we are all the same. My mother, a very glorious woman, when she was pregnant with child.
With you, Master?
I'm afraid so. She was denied lodging at a local inn in Bethlehem because she was so different. She was forced to give birth in a manger.
I'm sorry.
Why are you sorry, Thomas?
Because I understand. Because I am a poor fisherman and I've been mistreated because of it.
My father was right. We are all of the same. But you will find that when you are righteous, kings will find you and kneel at your feet. Come. Then it will be my father's will, that is. Thank you, Messiah, for gracing our home with your presence. I am humble. You are blessed. Stand. Show me to your master. Yes. Blessings upon you, good man. Shall you share a feast with us?
I would like nothing better, Rabbi, but this is your time, and I dare not intrude. Besides, I must go downstairs and watch the door. My servant here will assist in anything else you may need.
Thank you.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam borei pri hagafen.
Eloheinu melech haolam borei pri hagafen.
Amen.
Baruch atah
Today, my loved ones, we sit together in remembrance of our exodus as Jews from slavery in Egypt. My father instructed the Israelites of old to place the blood of a virgin lamb on their doorpost. And only then the plague smiting the firstborn in all of Egypt would pass over them. Today, and for 7 days, we sit in remembrance of this glorious Passover. But there is another reason we have gathered tonight. Verily I say unto you, one of you shall betray me.
What? What? Master.
No.
Earlier in the garden, my father spoke with me and told me that one of you that dips in the sop with me shall betray me.
No, Master, it's impossible. Everyone at this table loves you.
Do you call my father a liar, Thomas?
No.
Master, who is this traitor?
Is it me, Master?
Is it me, Master?
My sister.
Who would do this?
His hands are indeed at this table.
Whoever this traitor be, let him reveal himself now, before any harm comes to our master. For soon, I promise you, that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed, wish he had never been born.
How do we know the traitor isn't you, Peter?
Peter?
What?
Me.
No.
I question you, Thomas, for whom it came so hard to accept the Messiah.
Do you really wish to kill me, Peter? Master.
Please stop this.
Peter. Enough. My father shall deal with the traitor in his own way. All I needed was a little more time. But my hour draws near.
We don't understand, Master.
You have always been so naive, John. You will come to understand that through my death will come much life. The sins of the world will be washed away.
We all love you, Master. And I believe every man here would give his life
for you.
Master, we have all loved you for years. What makes you think that we would ever, ever do anything to hurt you?
Nonsense! Absolute nonsense!
Do you think you love him more than us, Peter?
Not more than I!
I love him more than any of you ever will.
Black Nazarene and his followers take a noisy feast. There is a reward for his capture. Come.
Tell us, Master. Who among us loves you more? And who in death shall be next to you in your father's kingdom?
James, how can you ask the Messiah such a question?
We've all been thinking about it. Whispering it among ourselves for weeks now. I think we have a right to know.
Let them speak. Continue, James.
Master, it is clear you love us all. But we wish to know, who is the greatest among us 12?
Greatest? For who is great? He that sits at the table, or he that serves? He who is greatest among you shall be the one who chooses to serve. And I will appoint unto him, that servant, a kingdom as my father has given to me. After I am gone, you will continue to serve mankind with the teachings I have given you. Then, and only then, will you share in my glory? Remove your sandals so that I may wash your feet. Do you not obey your master, Peter?
Master, I will never let you wash my feet.
If I do not wash your feet, Peter, then you will have no part of me.
In that case, don't just wash my feet. Wash my hands and my head as well, so that I may have all of you.
You need only wash your feet, Peter, and you are clean. But some of you will never be clean.
Some say he shows the tendencies of a cult leader. Possibly he is the Messiah.
But Nicodemus, how can you abandon the teachings of the Torah and even suggest that?
I said possibly.
A prophet? He might be. But a Messiah as foretold by the Torah?
The very Torah tells us the Messiah will descend from the line of David.
And so?
And this man is from that very lineage.
As were countless others.
But he was also born in Bethlehem, as was foretold by the prophets.
Rabbis,
these two have word where the Black Nazarene has taken refuge.
Is that true?
Yes, Rabbi. We seen him with our own eyes.
I've already notified the prefect.
You may leave us. Tell us what you have seen.
There is a small matter of reward for information on a false prophet.
5 pieces of silver. If your information leads us to the man we seek.
The Nazarene travels with 12 followers.
Are they armed?
Forgive me, fellow rabbis, but perhaps we should notify Caiaphas immediately.
Caiaphas will be quick to respond. We need to know if they are armed, lest we send soldiers to seize them that may be overpowered and slaughtered.
Do you want their blood on your hands, Gamaliel?
This day may be our last Passover together. It is just a matter of time before I am captured and killed.
We'll be met with swords before we let that happen.
It is too late, Peter. This is the cup of my blood. The blood of the everlasting life. It will be given up for you. For all men. Do this in memory of me. I shall not drink again. Until it is fulfilled in my Father's kingdom. This bread is not just bread. It is my body, which shall be given up for you. Share in my flesh. Thank you.
Have any of you seen a black Jew? He travels with a dozen men.
A black Jew? I've seen no black Jews.
Search the house.
Where are they? Under penalty of death, you best answer in truth.
If I find that you are lying. On my word, soldier, I've seen no one. We were just having Passover dinner.
My father speaks the truth, really. There's no one like that here. Please.
Parishes, we searched the house. Nothing.
I promise to seek you out if I should see him. Please.
Jews.
Go!
Father, what's so special about tonight?
Because on this night, we celebrate our freedom as Jews, each of us, as though Moses had led us out of the wilderness only yesterday.
Where is he?
We have not seen him.
You lie.
He is my son, yes. But do you see him here with us? We gave him up a long time ago.
Search the house.
Yes, Horatius.
It has begun.
Our time left here is short, my loved ones. We must leave quickly.
We will see you safely, Master.
Peter, Satan demanded to have you so that he may sift through you like wheat. But I pray for you.
It never will. You heard my word, Rabbi. I'll always be by your side.
What if I told you that before the rooster crows twice tonight, you shall betray knowing me three times?
Peter, deny you, Lord.
How could Peter?
I'd see any of us deny you before Peter.
Please. Please, Master. Don't tell me this.
But I shall pray for you.
How can Peter's faith be shaken?
I don't understand this.
You will all fall away.
Master. I saw the good man in the house allow him in, with the other of his group stood and watch. Rabbis, they make their Passover right now. You must send soldiers for them quickly before they can escape.
It is true, Joseph of Arimathea, Nicodemus, they really should.
Must I hear from the Romans that Nazarene has been found?
Is it true?
Yes, Rabbi Caiaphas, it is true. These two have seen him. I kept insisting we should bring him in.
Is this true?
Yes.
We believe it is him.
This impostor is a threat to all of us. Gamaliel, order the guard to take 5 soldiers and follow this man to the house wherein hides this blasphemer.
Quickly, Master, this way.
Go.
You'll fear the lashments whipped for this good man.
Gladly.
What's wrong, Judas?
Rabbi. Maybe I should pick up some supplies for us. Where shall you and the rest be that I may find you?
chapter 7. I love you, Master. Judas, your way is not my way. But you go do what you must do.
Master, is it him?
Judas.
Yet, you let him steal all our donations and run off to betray you.
What is to be fulfilled, we cannot stop.
Disappear into the darkness. Marcus, you take several soldiers, head towards the eastern hillside.
The rest of us, we'll go north. Let's go. Disperse! They will be found.
We must put them all on the ground. Kill them!
Breathe a sound, Raider. Even in betrayal, he is glorious. And if it was not for our master, I would open your throat.
Yeah!
Judas!
What are you doing here? The streets are dangerous.
Come with me quickly, lest you be discovered as one of Yashu's followers.
I hold you both accountable for allowing this heretic to slip through our fingers. Herod will know of this.
We are keepers of the Torah. We should not involve Rome in a strictly Jewish issue.
This carpenter has incited difficulties ever since he came to the district. The Romans will make it their problem.
As if their presence in Judea wasn't enough already. I have seen their centurion guards march about this place as if it was their own backyard. Let's give them no more reason.
Gentlemen, I'm not convinced that this Yeshua of Nazareth is the threat he's purported to be.
It is true, Rabbi. We've seen so many false prophets.
What makes this man different than any man who claims to be the Messiah?
Surely. How many such men have we seen in recent years? 10? 20? What makes this carpenter and his army of 12 fishermen such a terrible threat?
You wish to see the difference? Go, look outside and see the difference.
Now is not the time, Judas.
When is it ever the time?
Where are the others? Is Yashua all right?
As best I know, yes. He and the others escaped into the hillside, towards Gethsemane.
Why did you not go with them?
Yeshua sent me for supplies. If not for you stopping me, I'd be at the marketplace. Mary Magdalene, why do you stare at me so?
I know Yeshua loves you greatly. Why would he risk sending you into town?
I told you he sent me for supplies.
Where are your supplies?
I had no time. The crowd, I feared for my life.
If you were on your way to the temple precinct, would you betray him, Judas?
My actions would never betray him. Only force his hand.
To following your way?
It is the only way. Violence is the only language these Romans speak. It is foolish to think we could drive him out of Judea by spreading brotherhood and performing miracles. They laugh at us. But trust me, they will not laugh when they feel the sting of 1,000 Jewish swords.
And then what? They will send a whole army to overpower you.
Then we'll raise a bigger army.
His way was foretold by the scriptures, Judas. Do you doubt he is the Messiah?
I believe he may be. But it is his passive ways I find fault with.
Judas, he is a man of peace.
Peace won't drive out the Romans.
His way will succeed much faster than your army of zealots.
You say that, Only because it is easier to love a Messiah than a fisherman. What is it you see in him that is not in me?
The truth.
Where is my truth?
Fine. Would you like a feast your master has yet to enjoy?
The countless speaks of the Messiah is a man of peace. Yes! Peace to strength and power!
Absolute glory!
You will come as a mighty king, arriving on horseback, leading a great army of warriors! Where is this Nazarene's army? I see only an army of fishermen!
Who is this black Nazarene think he is?
Oh, he proclaims that he rules over the kingdom of heaven. A kingdom of dark-skinned Jews. Well, I will be a part of no such kingdom.
Yes!
Nothing good ever came from Nazareth.
Go, Abaddon, go! Go tell them! Tell Caiaphas what you know about this false prophet!
Tell him, Abaddon! He blasphemes!
Where's Mama?
Shh. Mama is resting. Come help us.
What business do you have here, woman?
I wish to speak to you.
What does she want? Tell her to go. There is no room for sinners here.
Attend to your mother.
But, Papa, she...
Now! Speak.
I have come in hopes of saving the life of your son.
What about my son?
Judas goes now to betray him to the Sanhedrin.
Judas, by my own hands, I...
There is no time. We must hurry and warn the Messiah. He and his followers have sought refuge in the mountains of Gethsemane.
How do you know this?
Judas tonight.
You did what?
Only to delay the peace so that Yeshua would have more time to escape.
But I cannot stand in judgment of the profession by which you've chosen to live your life, Mary Magdalene. But my son did forgive your sins, and he is greater than us all.
Thank you.
We must hurry, but I will get noticed. Mary will accompany you.
My mother is hurt the most. She understands the journey I have taken, the journey that I must take, because I love you.
I love you too, Thomas. My father loves you.
But she is a woman of old, and I'm her youngest son. I hope she doesn't think I'm a disappointment.
A disappointment, Thomas. You have been chosen to carry my message. How can that be a disappointment? It is my father's message. And when I am long gone, men will speak of us. How the Son of God came
fulfill a prophecy with the help of 12 chosen men.
But, Master, my mother thinks I've left my fishing nets behind to take up with a false prophet. That I have given up my real service.
Is that what you believe, Thomas?
No. Master, I believe in you with every fiber that is me.
I know you've all been under a great deal of strain. The running, the hiding.
There are rumors that they're looking for us. And we might be killed.
Are you afraid, Andrew?
I am.
Who else among you is afraid? This grain of wheat. If I throw it on the ground, there it will lie and die. But only when it dies can it bear fruit. In my death, there will be life.
Have you brought all of us here to die, Master?
They are looking for us. But they only want
Master, it is not safe.
Master, do not leave us yet. It is still early.
I have to go speak with my father.
Perhaps I should come to you, Master. Tonight, much danger lurks in the darkness.
And we'll go as well.
Come.
Tell us about this Yosha, since you speak so publicly of him.
My neighbor is a blind man, and has always been so. This Nazarene came upon him and laid hands on him. And all at once, my neighbor could see.
This is sacrilege! He should be arrested!
There is no crime in restoring sight to a blind man.
It is a blessing that the man may see.
Shh! Continue.
After restoring the man's sight, the Nazarene told him of a kingdom in heaven where he would have everlasting happiness.
See, this Nazarene speaks nothing against the Torah.
I profess to you, Caiaphas, this Yeshua is nothing
forgive
more than...
Forgive me, Rabbi. But there is more.
Let him speak.
Continue.
This Yeshua from Nazareth, this false prophet, said the only way to enjoy the kingdom of heaven is through him.
Through him?
What, he's a gatekeeper?
He said through him. Because he is the Son of God.
The Son of God.
He should be arrested.
He blasphemes!
Are you sure those were the Nazarene's exact words, Abaddon?
I swear on my own life.
You see, rabbis, this is what was meant by the vision had by Isaiah in the Talmud.
You are most insightful, young Joshua.
Yes. Tell us, Yoshua, how is it that a boy of 12 could have so much knowledge?
My knowledge of the scriptures is granted by my father.
It could be said that all knowledge is granted by God. How is it that your knowledge rivals the wisdom of rabbis who have devoted their entire lifetimes to study?
Because I am the Son of God.
You may speak.
Rabbi, I know three men that the so-called king laid hands on. One of them, Lazarus, brother to Martha and Mary of Bethany, was supposedly brought back to life.
I've heard the rumors.
But there is but one who has the power to summon a cold body up from the grave and breathe life into it.
Satan.
He speaks the truth. No godly man would awaken a body from its grave. After the Almighty God, in all his wisdom, has taken him.
It's bold. Crazy.
And there are more stories like this.
And what do you think now? I thought so.
There he is.
He is named Judas.
Well. We have been waiting for you, Judas of Iscariot. Have you come to tell us their location?
I have.
Where are they hiding?
In Gethsemane.
Gethsemane? A dozen poor fishermen hiding in Gethsemane? Tell us, Judas. Gethsemane is a place of rest and relaxation visited by only the wealthy. Why would fishermen hide there?
Maybe he figures it's a place where we wouldn't think to look.
He is very clever.
You've done very well, Judas of Iscariot. The agreement was for 30 pieces of silver, correct?
I can't stand it, watching you go through this. Can't we just make our way up the Kidron Valley?
Leave here. And then what? If only I could.
I don't want any part of it. Sitting there like sheep, waiting for them to take you away.
Do you really love me, Peter?
With all my heart. You know I do.
You take this while I go pray. Eli, asutite. Eli, Eli, alertele, asutite. Green, but sahi. Rin, bayet netra.
Yeah.
Really care, Peter?
I don't understand.
I ask you to wait for me, to watch over me for 1 hour while I go speak with my father. And you couldn't even do that.
We were
excuses.
Just a little...
Excuses! All I ever hear... I am tired. Don't you think I am tired? But you have to fight off the sleep. Beware of the flesh and anything that is tempting. Because the flesh is weak. Even if the spirit is willing. Beware, Peter. Beware of temptation.
Wait, somebody must do this.
Yesterday they cheered a fisherman prophet who rides a donkey. Today they cheer the man who betrayed him.
Who can understand these Jews?
As a man, I must have my views heard. This Yeshua of Nazareth is nothing but a carpenter with a gift of the knowledge of the scriptures. Perhaps he is plagued with a mental deficiency which causes him to think that he is the Messiah. Where is the harm?
He's able to convince only his fisherman followers and a sprinkling of others.
A sprinkling of others? Rabbis, I fear that you have both spent far too long in this temple.
The Nazarene and his disciples, they are known far and wide. He is turning the opinion of thousands.
He is just one man. You speak of him as if he is the king of Jews he professes himself to be. Maybe you dispute what's written in the Torah.
Why, Yosef of Arimathea.
Shh, quiet.
Rabbis, get hold of yourselves. We merely sent for him.
We're not sentencing him.
It's one and the same.
It is my wish.
If I may suggest, Caiaphas, that whatever are the opinions of us in here, we bring him in for his own safety. The crowds would kill him if they found him first.
Oh,
How much further? I hope we're not too late.
The Romans and their heavy armor and boots cannot get along these paths as easily as we can. They must travel a different road. We will get to Gethsemane before they do.
How is it that you know of this path?
Many wealthy men spend time in Gethsemane. When they desire my company, they'd much rather be in places unseen.
Go!
How armed are these fishermen?
His men have but four swords among them. But they will not fight.
A group of fishermen with four swords and no will to fight? I could have carried this mission out myself.
Horatius, do you remember Marius? Large man, red hair, trained us in the lance.
Oh yes, I remember him. Always joked about killing Jews with his lance.
He washed over in our journey here.
A shame. He was a man who was born to his work. Lucky he did not live to see this day. Roman officers being sent by Jews to capture Jews. What has our empire become?
No. No.
Having second thoughts, Judas? Always happens to traitors.
What is it, Jew?
What is it?
I know a shorter way.
Go!
Issue. One last commandment to you all.
Anything, Master.
After I die, my work and message must not die. They will win only if they succeed in silencing my message. They're mistaken.
What do you want us to do?
James, John, my sons of thunder. You will speak in my voice, and you will tell the others that they must sell everything of value so that they can spread my message. All of you, outside Jerusalem, towards Syria, Asia, past the Black Sea, the Mediterranean, and so on.
But how? There are only 12 of us.
12 shall become 1,000. And 1,000, 10,000, and 1,000,000, and more.
We will do this.
Good. My message will not die.
Drop your weapon!
Which of you is Yoshua of Nazareth?
I am he.
He lies. I am Yoshua.
You are not black enough, Jew. Arrest them all!
Protect yourselves!
Enough!
I will come peacefully.
You betray me with a kiss, Judas. The prophecy must be fulfilled.
I will come.
Time to meet your future, Nazarene. Let's go.
You may ask.
How does it feel to be different?
In my father's eyes, Thomas, we are all different. Yet we are all the same.
Should I?
Master, what has happened to you?
Do you really care, Peter?
I don't understand.
I ask you to wait for me. Watch over me for 1 hour while I go speak with my father. And you couldn't even do that.
We were just a little...
Excuses! All I hear are excuses. Don't you think I am tired? But you have to fight the sleep and everything that is tempting of the flesh. Even when the spirit is willing. Beware, Peter. Beware of temptation. Lasting life. It will be given up to you.
Us.
Enough! Our master is gone! Yeshua is dead.
I am here.
Mary Magdalene.
Peace, my brother.
The situation has become complicated.
I wanted to wash my hands of this business.
But how could this be?
I have great news. He has risen.
You doubt your master, is it?
What have I done? Please forgive me.
I've heard of this man before. To Sai, Holy Mother. We should be thanking you.
It is the Lord.
Elijah, something is definitely coming.
And blood. I will forever beg for forgiveness. His blood is on our hands. We have killed the Messiah. We have killed the Son of God. Eli, lama azeftani. Lama azeftani. Eli. Mama, as if today.
have done. Lily, Lama Zeftani. Lama Zeftani. Lily. Lama Azaftani. Slack, Lahim, Ki, Enam, Yotin, Mai, Kcheosim, Slack. I have ki enam yotin ma sheosim
The skies went dark. From the sixth hour to the ninth, there was no sun, no moon, no stars, nothing but blackness. It was a day that would be recorded time and time again. It was a day the world would never forget. No one was prepared for what was to come.
They're calling us liars, Father. The villagers are all talking about it.
They say we are the relatives of a false prophet.
He was my son, not theirs. They have no right to judge you or him.
Can I ask you this, Father?
What, Jude?
Do you love all of your sons equally?
Why would you ask such a silly question? I love you all the same.
Then listen to us. Even as we mourn, Father, we fear for our lives and yours. Mother can't go to the market without...
Yes, I worry about your mother. But that's only because she lost her son.
There are 332 written prophecies in the Torah. The Messiah, as it says, must fulfill them all.
Do you doubt Yeshua is the Messiah, Jude?
Can you confirm that he was? Didn't he grow up in this house with you? And yet, what proof do you have?
Please, let's not speak of this anymore. We have unfinished work to do.
All I am trying to say is that all of this talk about him being the Messiah, it led him to believe it. And his antics finally caused his death.
He's your brother. He's your brother, Jude.
Yes, and I loved him. But he hurt this family's good name.
Enough! How many times must my heart be broken today? I have just watched my son suffer the cruelest of deaths, handed over by one of his own followers. Yahshua died for us. He died for you. He sacrificed himself. How can you sit there and deal him this final blow?
We were just talking, Mother.
This is his blood, which I wiped from his torn brow. How can you sit there and speak of him like this? James, do you not remember when you could not sell your own crafted furnishings? You raised the price of his so that people would buy from you instead. He did that because he loved you. And Jude, was it not him who gave you the land that was rightfully his? Because you accused him of not being Joseph's true son. Again, because he loved you. And they've killed him. You are his brothers. And whether you can accept what he was, can you at least love him for that?
Prefect, these men wish to speak with you. A petition for the body of the man they call King of the Jews.
See the man. So, you've come to request the body.
Yes, I have. Rome has no need for it.
And how do you presume to know what Rome needs? To be so quick to forget that your position holds no power here.
The people. Some considered this Nazarene to be a prophet.
They followed him, they demand the body. He should have a proper burial.
And why would a member of the Sanhedrin Council come to me and request such a thing? Was he not a criminal by your Jewish laws?
Yes, sir, but the situation has become complicated.
You Jews can never make up your mind. Was it not your council that handed him over to Roman authority? And was it not your council that deemed this man a blasphemer and a false prophet?
Yes, it was the council.
And are you not a member of this council?
Yes, but I...
But what? Are your thoughts not aligned with the council's decision to execute this man? Fine. It's all the same to me. You can have the body of your king. But don't be fickle. You change your mind and bring him back to me, and you won't find me in such a state of kindness.
Of course, this will be the last time you hear of this.
Darling, I've heard of this man before. What will you do?
I wanted to wash my hands of this business.
In death, he seemed only a man. He no longer seemed to be the Messiah.
Eli. Eli. Allah tenli. Asutite. Eli. Ellie! Allah, tell me!
Nazareth.
It's Bein Batsahi. Rein Bayet Netra.
This bread is not just bread. It is my body, which shall be given up for you. Share in my flesh.
This man loved me like no other. I believed he was who he said he was. I believed he was the Messiah, here to redeem the Jews.
What do we do now, Peter?
Pray, John. Our master is gone. At this point, what else can we do?
But what of us now?
But what of us now? What of our master?
And do you look to me for answers, John? I'm not fit to be your leader. Ask him.
I'm sorry.
Has anyone heard anything of Judas?
He was a traitor. What of him? May he rot in the darkest corners of hell.
Master would bestow you to forgive him.
He will receive no forgiveness from me.
We have to leave here. We're not safe anywhere in the province of Judea.
And where do you propose we go, Andrew?
Anywhere but these mountains. Perhaps the Kidron Valley.
Don't be foolish. There's only one road out of Judea. Surely you can't think the Romans haven't thought of that.
I say we go back. Ask for leniency.
Have you lost your mind? But what of our master?
Enough! Our master is gone!
Do you think they've thrown him in jail?
There were three executions early today. Our master was among them. Yeshua is dead.
After he died, in 3 days he would return.
He did say this. He did.
He did say it.
Yeah, I remember too.
Then we should wait here for him. Till the 3 days have passed.
But what if he doesn't?
Do you doubt our master?
Peter.
He who lives by the sword dies by the sword.
He will return. Our master is faithful. He's never lied to us, Thomas. You must believe.
So what are we supposed to do? Just stay up here on this desolate mountain? With no food, no water?
Man does not live on food alone. Have you forgotten, Thomas?
Any news on Yahshua's family?
I saw them. Briefly. As our master was being taken away. That was the last time.
I'm going into town to look for food. Is anyone coming with me?
I'll join you.
I will come also.
May the Lord, our master, be with you.
So, what have we to gain from the burial of this Nazarene? Tell me, Joseph of Arimathea, how do you think this makes us look in the eyes of the Roman authorities? We condemn a man, and then we ask for proper burial?
I care only how I look in the eyes of God.
And we do not?
How dare you suggest it? We work and we study all day, only to serve the wishes of God.
Of course. I did not mean otherwise.
Tell me, Joseph of Arimathea, how do you think God looks at a man like this Nazarene? A man who claims that he can destroy the Holy Temple and rebuild it in 3 days?
He spoke not of this visible temple, but the temple of his body. God sees no differences in the bodies of men. They are all his children.
It is obvious that you have affection for this false prophet. Perhaps you would like to share in his fate.
Yes. He stood in this very room, exactly where you stand now. And yet you offered no defense for him then. Why have you come to his aid now, after his body has been broken?
Every man must make his own case. It was not for me to speak in his favor.
He blasphemed.
He called himself the Son of God.
Is he on trial again? You have done with him as you wished. His body now lies broken, sealed in a tomb. The time for justifying these actions has passed.
And what of your actions? Granting the burial of this false prophet? Did you not think it would be against the council's wishes?
I have done in my heart what I thought was right. Is right, after one witnessed such a great wrong. This man was treated harshly, beyond the limits of his punishment. I have done what I have done, and I do not regret it. My fate is in the hands of the council. Do with me as you wish.
All right, then. Does anyone wish to speak on behalf of Joseph of Arimathea?
See a large tree, what of it?
But what is attached to the tree? It looks like the body of a man.
I can see it.
Ah. Well, John, there is your answer. There hangs Judas, the betrayer.
Do you think the Romans did it?
Who could know? Maybe robbers.
Well, he handed our master over to be killed as well. This is nothing less than what he deserves. We should cut him down from the tree. let the birds eat his carcass.
Simon, this man was once like a brother to us.
Well, may the wolves leave nothing but his rotten bones.
He deserved it, Thomas. His mind was poisoned. Come, we must tell the others.
Nicodemus, what is it?
There is no time. The council got rid of the burial. Caiaphas sent Pilate to go put two guards in front of the tomb.
We must seal the tomb and leave this place immediately. We can't let the Romans destroy the body.
The council? The angry, the auctions? They consider it betrayal.
Deliver these quickly. The senator waits.
Yes, sir.
Pilate, please forgive this imposition.
Yes, I know you wouldn't come to see me during your Passover if it wasn't a matter of grave importance. What is it?
It concerns the false prophet.
Yeshua, yes. I've given his followers permission to bury the body.
It's about these followers that we have come to speak with you.
Surely 12 fishermen could be of little concern to you and your council. Put them out of your mind.
Of course. But his following has grown. Even your own troops have been swayed.
Nonsense. Troops believe what their commanders tell them to believe.
All the same, our concern is that his followers will steal the body.
Look, I can't be concerned with a few grave robbers. Tension in the city is at an all-time high. I need my men to patrol the marketplace.
This could be devastating to the council.
You fear an uprising.
I fear the worst.
Very well. Take two of my best guards, have them sit over the tomb for 3 days. Protect it as best you know how.
Thank you, sir.
Everything so final. Even though I had witnessed the brutal slaying of my master, I hadn't acknowledged his death until they sealed the tomb. Even in his death, he threatened them, those who would not accept, those who refused to believe.
Here it is. Your instructions are
to go. You have no power over me, Jew. I'm a Roman officer.
By order of Pontius Pilate, you are to guard this tomb. No one is to enter or leave.
No one is getting out, and we'll make sure nobody gets in either. Your criminal is safe with us, Rabbi.
We'll stand here by order of the Senate. No one will pass.
Know your task. Should anyone enter or leave, you will have failed.
The man that freed me. The man that released me from the torture of 7 evil demons.
Mary Magdalene!
Who is it?
It's me, Mary, mother of your joy.
Oh.
sorry this has all happened. I'm sorry for your loss.
It is the world's loss.
Yes. I'd like to visit the tomb. I'd like to leave some flowers and pay my respects once again. Would you like to come with me?
Yes. After this happened, we will go.
How did we draw such a dull assignment?
These are our orders, and we will follow them. What would you rather be doing?
Anything but these. Patrolling the marketplace, maybe.
Nothing but unruly Jews in the markets. I am happy to watch this dead Jew behind this boulder.
Couldn't we simply have a few pages guard this too? No one would dare break the Sanhedrin Council's seal, even if they could move this boulder.
Enough. You are a Roman.
I was thinking, what if this
man is... I was thinking that you are a disgrace to the regiment. When was the last time you polished your armor?
Do you remember what happened after this man was crucified?
Those were merely rumors. Now act like a soldier, and let's guard this tomb for 3 days. And then maybe after, we could get some real action.
The sky did turn black. I saw it with my own eyes. I saw the craftsmen entering the temple. They were carrying cloths to rehang the curtains.
You are like a child.
What if he is the Messiah? What if he is the Son of God?
Then let him roll away the boulder. Let him walk out of the grave. And I will call him the Son of God myself.
I'm just saying. The council's deemed this man a criminal. A traitor against God's law.
I want to thank you, Joanna, for all you did for my son when he was alive.
No, to sigh, Holy Mother. We should be thanking you for giving to the world the Messiah. Now, what of the disciples?
I spoke with Thomas earlier. A terrible thing has befallen Judas of Iscariot. He was found hung by the neck from a branch of a tree on the south side of the mountains where the disciples are hiding. They are in danger.
The word in the temple precincts is that Judas himself handed your son to the Sanhedrin.
This is what I was told by those who were there.
And the Sanhedrin?
There are a few believers. Joseph Arimathea petitioned for the body and won. Although this was against the council's wishes, they would not look favorably upon him.
I will forever be grateful to him. I will pray that the Sanhedrin Council will be merciful.
He's been imprisoned by the Sanhedrin in the province of Rome.
No. Locked away simply for giving a Jew a proper burial.
Caiaphas and the Council saw Yeshua as a criminal. I'm sorry.
Councils deem this Jew a criminal, a traitor against God's law.
Something was wrong. The peace of my master's grave had been disturbed, and for the first time since his death, I was shaken with fear. Yeshua!
You have come to this place for Yeshua of Nazareth, he who has been crucified.
Yes. What has happened to the body of my master?
Why do you look for the living amongst the dead? Your Lord is not here. He has risen. He has risen and gone ahead of you to Galilee. Tell his brothers to go there, and there they will see him. He will wait near the sea.
I don't understand.
Remember how he told you, the Son of Man must be delivered into hands of sinful men, be crucified, and on the third day be raised again.
Yes, he did say that. He said it more than once to those who followed him.
What he has told you has become so. Go, tell his brothers the good news.
Forgive me for this intrusion, rabbis.
What is the meaning of this?
These Roman soldiers have news about this false prophet.
Come, come, let them enter.
I'm afraid I've come with some bad news.
Oh?
News that will definitely upset this council.
What is this news?
It seems that the body of the Nazarene has been taken from the tomb.
How can that be?
I don't understand this. Did you or your men leave the tomb?
No one left. I had my best men over there.
How could this be? Who could have rolled that stone away from in front of that tomb? It would take 10 men.
Someone must be held accountable.
How could this have happened?
It seems as though those who were guarding the tomb were scared off by an earthquake and blinding light.
No.
The soldiers are here. Would you like to inquire on the matter yourself?
Yes. I want to speak to these Roman soldiers that can't perform a simple task as guarding a dead man.
How can they? Jewish priests betraying one of their own.
Lining their coffers. That's their idea of God's work. That's what I think of the Sanhedrin Council.
Thomas received word from town. The one of the priests gave our master a proper burial.
Maybe things have settled with the council. Perhaps we don't have to remain in hiding.
I can tell you that they're waiting for us to emerge. And then they'll kill us. All of us. We're his followers.
He's gone. The body is just gone.
What do you mean it's gone?
What he means to say is that the body of your so-called false prophet is gone, out of the tomb.
Impossible.
I wouldn't believe it myself, but I was there. The boulder, it rolled away.
Stones don't just roll away. You Roman soldiers, you're the best.
What were you supposed to do?
This will jeopardize everything. How could you tell such a story? A man raising from the dead.
Are you questioning my honor? I swear on the allegiance to Rome that is exactly as we saw.
I care not for your allegiance to any nation.
The stone simply rolled away. It was a great light from within.
No single man could have moved the boulder. No torch could have made such a great light.
And the earth, it trembled, knocked us off our feet.
We've heard enough of your tale. Give us some time to think. The story gives the Yeshua's claim of resurrection some weight.
This must not reach the people's ears.
Perhaps we can reach a different arrangement.
You are not to repeat this story. Only the council knows it, yes?
We saw some women.
Only a known prostitute and the grieving mother of the false prophet. We told them nothing.
Then from now on, you will tell a different tale. You are to say, his disciples came in the middle of the night and stole them away while we were asleep.
For your trouble.
It will be as you say.
I
heard that the stone had been rolled away. A huge boulder.
Where were the Roman guards?
This is what I can't understand. See, they were there to guard the tomb. There were two of them. But then they're seen running in his way, naked of all their armor, as fast as they could toward the temple.
I heard the temple had been destroyed by an unknown force.
What are you discussing?
The recent events here in Jerusalem.
What things?
Have you not heard?
Are you a visitor to Jerusalem? Yeshua of Nazareth.
He was a prophet.
Oh, I see.
The chief priest had sentenced him to death.
We're hoping he was the one to redeem Israel.
And you believe that he is not?
What's more, this all took place 3 days ago. Some of the women went to his tomb and his body was missing.
They said they'd seen angels and said that he was alive.
How foolish you are. How slow of heart to believe what the prophets have spoken. Did not Christ go through these things and enter into his glory?
Yes, he is right.
Stranger. We must go find the 11. It is true, he has risen.
The Romans are worse than dogs.
This may be true. But we cannot fight them, Simon.
They have the greatest army on earth.
There is no army greatest than the army of God.
This is very hard for all of us, because we were here when they took him away.
I fought. I cut the ear of a Roman guard with this very dagger.
Yeah, but they still took him away, Peter.
He went willingly. I must admit, I was afraid.
So was I.
I am blind. Please help me. Charity for blind men. Charity, please. Charity for blind man, please. Help me, please, please. Please.
What is it that you are praying for?
I'm praying for the soul of the Messiah.
Have you seen him?
I knew him when he was a young man. He was from this very place and was driven away by his own people. I have heard of all the amazing things he has done in the province of Judea. I could have healed my sight. Are you a native of Nazareth? Do you know of whom I speak?
Yes, I am he.
Sinners, the children. He appeared to those who would see him, those who would believe in him, and at the same time, he would appear to those who didn't even know who he was.
What is it?
I have great news.
What news?
What are you talking about?
Yeshua, the Messiah. He's alive.
That's impossible. Don't joke about such things. Let my family grieve in peace.
But it is true. I have word from the disciples, and I know where they are. I must go tell them at once. He's the Messiah. He has risen.
You know this is dangerous. You could be arrested or killed if caught.
They asked me to bring Mary.
Father, no.
Where are they?
They are in a mountainside outside Arimathea. They need food.
Well, we have no food to give them.
What little we have, we share. I cannot speak for Mary.
I saw too. He spoke to Mary Magdalene. The stone was rolled away. The tomb was empty.
I have news of the disciples. They are hiding in the mountainside with no food. I, along with Joanna, will take them some. Will you come?
Mother, no. You need rest, for your mind isn't in the right place.
Not to mention it may still be dangerous. There still may be Romans scouring the hills.
These men were his family for many years. They are my family. I want to tell them. I will go.
Then I will go too.
We will all go.
News of the Messiah was already spreading. Had he risen? Yes. I saw him with my own eyes. I felt his clothes and kissed his feet. I have no doubts.
Okay, we're all here.
How is this possible? How could Yeshua still be alive?
You all saw him. We must believe.
And we do. That is why we met in Galilee.
You saw the Lord in the flesh in Tiberias, yet you still do not believe?
I will believe. I will believe when I can touch him with my own hands, when I can see him with my own eyes. I will believe when he pres... I'm ashamed that I ever doubted you. But how can this be?
He stands in front of you, Thomas, and you still do not believe? You are the Messiah. Praise be to God.
My Lord.
My faith is no longer faith alone. I know that the Lord is with me. He is with us all. My faith alone had granted me this chance to see my master, but I still feared once again it would be my last.
What shall we do when we get there?
We shall see our master.
Yes, but then what?
We will do what our risen master tells us to do.
Unless I can see the nail marks in his hands and put my fingers where the nails were. Unless I can feel the wounds on his side, I will not believe.
Tomas, the Lord should not have to satisfy your doubts. Why can you have no faith?
My faith is strong, but my mind is unsatisfied.
I don't know if my heart will stand this journey.
Patience.
Peter, you're not the one to talk about patience.
Soon, my brothers, we shall see our risen master, and nothing else in this world will matter.
I'm sorry, Holy Mother. I denied him. 3 times I denied him. And I swore I wouldn't. How can this be? He needed me. I could have stopped this, all of this. And now you say he lived.
He has risen, just like he said he would.
Thank you, Holy Mother. And yet I still do not understand.
you? Jude, wake up, brother.
Why are you waking me, James? What's troubling you?
I think that I was dreaming, but I believe someone was heckling me with stones while I was asleep.
It was just a dream. You need more sleep. Let me be.
It was you.
I am sleeping like you should be. Now stop bothering me.
It was Yeshua. It was Yeshua.
Your dreams don't hit you in the head. Stop being foolish.
But Mary Magdalene said that she saw him.
Mary Magdalene is mad. She only saw what she wanted to see.
But what about Mother? Surely you don't doubt her. I mean, what reason does she have to lie to us? What about these?
James, you look as if you have seen a ghost.
My eyes do deceive me. I must be asleep.
It is I. How is our mother?
She said she saw you. I didn't think she was in her right mind.
Really?
How are you?
Come and embrace your brother. Father, I have only a little time left.
Where have you been, son?
I have been with my heavenly Father. I have gone many places, but I have much work still to do.
I have been all over the province of Judea, telling the followers of your return.
The people say Mary Magdalene has been telling your story, but no one believes her.
Some of them are angry. They have become quickly divided, for the Sanhedrin council has told them your body has been stolen.
Yet, here I am.
How will we make them believe?
Many will doubt, my brothers. But everyone shall know what they need to know.
My brother, why don't you just show them? Prove us and Mary Magdalene right, and the others will believe.
Free will is a powerful thing, my brothers. Do not worry, but let us enjoy this time together. I've sent word for my brothers to meet near the Sea of Galilee on the third day. There, I will leave instructions on delivering my message. The people will believe. Do you understand?
I am sorry I doubted you.
You are a good brother.
To fish. I'll catch us some breakfast.
If we wait for you to catch breakfast, surely we'll all starve to death.
I'll go with you.
I might as well come too. Make sure this is done right.
Why is it every time we go fishing, you manage to mess it up, Peter?
Yet again, we come up empty. I swear, Peter, you're cursed.
It is this net. It needs mending. How can we catch anything with such a net?
Do not blame the net for scaring away the fish, Peter.
You always talk too loud.
Nothing. Nothing.
Friends.
That old man is calling out to us.
What does he want?
We're only trying to catch some fish for breakfast. We'll be done soon.
Have you caught any fish today?
No. My friend here scares them all away.
Return to your basket.
What is he talking about?
Mark, do you see?
There's fish.
It is the Lord.
I have returned. Now that we have eaten as brothers, there is something I must ask. Peter, do you love me?
Yes, Lord, you know that I love you.
Then take care of my sheep. Feed my sheep. I must tell you that when you were younger, you did as you wanted. You dressed yourself and went wherever you wanted. But when you get old, you must have someone hold your hand and lead you and take you to where you must go.
What do you mean, Lord?
It is not for you to understand, Peter. Will you follow me?
Yes, Master, you know. I'd follow you to the ends of the earth.
Peter, the rock. Your sins are forgiven.
Hey, where do you think we're going?
Somewhere private. I'm sure our teacher has much to tell us.
Nonsense. We're going back to the temple.
We need to address the Sanhedrin council.
Yes. Show them that Yeshua is alive. He is arisen. Praise be to God.
Yeah, Thomas, like you were so quick to believe.
Let them see him. Then they will believe as I do.
No one knows how our Messiah spent those last hours with his disciples. But it was said their final hours together were glorious and a sight to behold. There are those who had heard of his resurrection, but still chose not to believe. Our Lord spoke of free will and did not force his presence upon them, but the world would change forever.
What do we do now, Lord?
Just as I have told you.
But where do we begin, Lord?
In your own hearts. You have witnessed my return. Now you must spread the good news to all those who believe so that their sins may be washed away.
But Lord, who will believe us?
In time, Thomas, the world shall believe.
What do we do now, Lord?
Therefore, go and make disciples of all the nations. Baptize them in the Holy Father, the Son, and the Spirit. The world will come to believe, so that they too may become believers. Everything I have taught you, that you have seen today, tens shall become thousands, and thousands millions. You must tell everyone what you have witnessed today. The world what you have seen today. Enam Yodin. Ma Sheosim. Flock, I have key in your teen. My shall see.